Welcome back, friends. In today's lecture, I am going to explain you about types of stele. Before that, I am going to say a brief introduction about what is stele. Stele, which is a spatial arrangement of primary vasculature of a stem organized into arrangements of xylem and phloem. The term stele for the first time was used by two scientists. They are tieghem and Douliot in 1886 in their stelar theory. Mainly, the stele which is a vascular cylinder with or without pith. Endodermis which is present within it, and it is acting like a boundary between cortex and pith. Means cortex and the stele which is present within the vasculature. And the stele which is used in reference to the primary xylem and phloem of roots as well as in stems. The scientist who is F.O.Bower, who proposed the variation in the size of, means the variation of the stelar is directly related to the size of the plant. And he has also mentioned means the ability to provide the primary vasculature and necessary nutrient and the photosynthate for the development of the plant. And later on, Stein, who made a model computer on the basis of hypothesis proposed by Wight, who proposed the ribbed steles of some Aneurophytaleans, means the ribbed steles of some Devonian Aneurophytalean taxa, which is developed by the hormones produced within it by the lateral appendages. On the basis of this theory only, they made a book. Very, very interesting. The fossil records they have taken and they have made, and they have taken the sections, everything. On the basis of the, they made the book, means some type of all types of variation are collected. And now let's see, on the basis of ontogeny and phylogeny, there are three broad categories of stele. They are protostele, siphonostele, and last but not least, that is solanostele. I am going to explain you in detail. Means there are different types within it. There are categories allotted within it. First of all, I am going to discuss you about what is protostele. Protostele, in which the central vasculature, the smooth central vascular, which is covered by the, means it is surrounded by the uniform layer of phloem. As we know, the protostele which is having the central smooth core of xylem, which is surrounded by the uniform layer of phloem. This is the main characteristics of the protostele, in which it is the most primitive type and which is the simplest type of protostele. Where there are five different kinds of protostele in pteridophytes. I am going to explain you each and every with examples. Now let's see. There are five types of protostele in pteridophytes. They are haplostele, actinostele, lactostele, mixed protostele, and last but not least, that is polystele. Now I am going to show, means in detail, we go through each and every, and what are the differentiation we can observe within it. Let's see. Now let's begin with haplostele. Haplostele, which is the primitive, which is the most primitive type of protostele, in which the central core of xylem, which is surrounded by the phloem, we can observe, where they form very primitive among protostele. And we can find this type of stele in fossil genera like Rhynia, Horneophytum, as well as we can also see in Celadinella stem and Glichemia. And last one thing, that is Dagodium. we can find this kind of stele in these plants. Now let's see how the actinostele appears. The most interesting, and I like the actinostele because it appears like a star shaped. Means the xylem, which is a star shaped and which has projections, they show stellate like projections, and the phloem, which is a covering outside of this, where this is considered to be advanced than haplostele. They are little bit advanced than haplostele, and the example for this is a Lycopodium serratum, and you can also find this kind of stele in a that is astroxylon. Astro, the name itself denotes the star, astroxylon. And one more example is also present within the this type of stele, that is astroxylon and a xylotum. You can see this kind of stele in these three plants. They are xylotum lower region, xylotum stem lower region, and Lycopodium serratum, as well as in you can see astroxylon. You can find this kind of stele. And now let's see how the protostele appears. The xylem, which is plate like and are arranged parallel to each other, and the east plate, which is surrounded by phloem, where they form very interesting shape, this protostele. You can observe how they have arranged the projections and the variation within it. That is very interesting to see. And we can find this kind of a stele in a Lycopodium clavatum. And these are considered to be more advanced than actinostele. In a sequential manner, we can observe the advancedness in the stele. In protostele, the first one, which is haplostele, very simple to see. And then it is converted into actinostele, and now the protostele, and the fourth one, which is we can observe here, that is mixed protostele. The xylem and phloem, which are distributed equally within the stele, and the xylem, which is broken up into the pieces, and they are covered by the phloem, and they form such a great thing within the envelope of the stele. And these mixed protostele are considered, means they are more advanced in protostele, and these are considered to be a transitional type between primitive protostele and advanced siphonostele. They are considered to be the transitional type. So these are the mixed protostele, and the example for this is a Lycopodium serratum. And we can also find one type of differentiation within it, that is the stele which is having the mixed protostele, which is having the pith within it, lining within it. And example for this is there are hymenophyllum denisum and the lipidodendron selaginoids. These are the two examples for mixed protostele with pith. You can find the pith within the stele. And now let's look the last one, that is polystele. Polystele is having a simple stele, the stem which is having the stele, and it is having a single row of, means xylem and phloem arranged within it. But in selaginella, the stem axis, which contains more than one type of stele. There are so many steles arranged, and they show the protostelic in nature only, but they contains more number of rings within it. And the best example is selaginella stem. Now let's go how this siphonostele looks. Siphonostele. Now let's see. Siphonosteles are means these are modified type of protosteles, in which the center region is occupied by the pith. The pith we can observe. We can see the pith which is present within this type of siphonostele. This is the unique feature, since we can easily differentiate the presence of pith in the siphonostele, whereas the pith which is absent in protostele. So the siphonostele is having the variation of having the pith within the center of it, and where they show enormous variation. And there are about three types of siphonostele. There are simple siphonostele, ectophloic siphonostele, and amphifloic siphonostele. Simple phloic siphonostele, in which it is having, means the pith region which is a parenchymatous or sclerenchymatous, we can't, means they may be parenchymatous or sclerenchymatous, in which the pith which is formed within the region, means it is formed either by the invasion of cortical tissue or interstitial, means the stele which is formed within the stellar evolution only. We can say how the variation is taken, it is different. And ectophloic siphonostele, in this type of stele, the central core which is occupied by the pith, in which xylem which is surrounded by the phloem, means the single layer of phloem is surrounded outside of the xylem. Well, the example for this is the best example, that is osmunda and chisia are the two examples for ectophloic siphonostele. And amphifloic siphonostele, in this type of stele, the central region which is occupied by the pith, but you can find a xylem which is covered by outer and inner sides, completely covered by the rings of phloem. You can see the xylem which is covered both on outer as well as inner sides by the phloem rings. An example for this is Marsilia, rhizome, and adiatom, where we can find this type of amphifloic siphonostele within these two plants. And now let's look how this solenostele appears. The interesting thing, the solenostele which is derived from the, means there are subcategory of siphonostele, in which siphonostele with one leaf gap on one point is called solenostele. It may contains ectophloic solenostele or amphifloic solenostele, in which they both are derived from the siphonophloic siphonostele, where they show the same similarity. Now let's go further into the dictyostele, how these dictyostele appear. Yeah, the dictyostele, which are means the siphonostele which is having the overlapping leaf gaps, siphonostele with overlapping leaf gaps forms the dictyostele, where the dissected amphifloic siphonostele also forms the dictyostele. Mainly the primary vasculature which is formed in the, means the primary vasculature which lies within the two gaps is known as, by the special term they have denoted, that is meristem. The primary vasculature which is present within the two gaps, and it is termed as meristem. The meristem which is a protostelic in nature, and the example for this is phlegms. We can observe this type of stele, as well as we can observe in the adiantum capillus veneris, we can find this type of stele. And one more, that is we can there are about two types of dictyostele. There are simple cyclic dictyostele and polycyclic dictyostele. In simple type, the dictyostele which are arranged in single ring. Polycyclic means the dictyostele which are having more than two rings. They are having more than two rings. The polycyclic siphonostele, which is a unique characteristics, and it contains more number of rings. An example for this is a Pteridophytes rhizome, where they formed a more number of rings within it. And now let's see how this U-stele looks. U-stele means the primary stem vasculature, which contains collateral or bicollateral conjoint vascular bundles, which are arranged around the pith. They are separately arranged around the pith. At the edges we can find, you can observe, we can find these vascular bundles which are arranged at the edges of the pith. This is the U-stele, and example for this is the lithopodium stem. We can observe, as well as in equisetum stems also we can find. In most formally we can see this type of stele in dicot stems. That is very interesting. And now let's see how this adactostele appears. These are similar to the U-stele, but they contains, means, but the two vascular bundles which are scattered and distributed within the lower region of the tissue. An example for this is monocot stems, where we can find this kind of steles which are arranged, scattered. And this is about the types of stele. I hope this video is helpful, and my examples are also very familiar, I think. If you feel any difficulty, go through this video one more time. You will definitely feel, because the images that I have collected and I have imprinted within the board, which are so helpful. And I will make a few more videos. You can comment me, and I will definitely take part in new videos. And I will welcome any comment, and I will take any topic which are very interesting. And do subscribe to my channel.